7,2424. Well, 424 is exactly 2 times 212. And 212 is the value of my full name. Yeah, I like to add up the values of words and letters. L is 12. It's the 12th letter of the alphabet. The angel is 72. But sadist is also 72. And Gabriel is a sadist. In 2019. Not always, but in 2019 she is. Names are just names. Every hurricane has its turn. Gabrielle, her turn is 2019 to be the bitch. She's a total bitch. She's a destroyer. And I hate to tell you this, if you live in Jacksonville, Florida, but she's heading your way. Not yet, but she's coming. Today's the 21st of August. It's Wednesday, and the Steamboat Geyser erupted last night. Well, it erupted at 51 minutes past midday, actually, in Wyoming, on the 20th, which is yesterday. There's going to be an eruption at 9:37 a.m. on Thursday, the 5th of September. That's the one that's going to warn for the bitch, Gabriel. This warning is coming from Gabriel, the angel Gabriel. Yeah, I do have a dictionary taped to my dashboard. There's 44,000 definitions in there. Do you want me to recite them all as I'm driving? Well, if you do want me to, it's going to be a pretty inaccurate recitation. Is that what you say? Recitation? A recitation. I'm going to do a recitation of the dictionary. Because I haven't even read it. I'm sure I've looked a few things up in there. I wonder if it has steamboat. Steamboat. What about disc jockey? DJ. I always say, it's weird, because I've always said Nathan and Jake are going to DJ for us while I'm driving. They're going to choose the songs. And sometimes it does seem like they do. The other day, it really seemed that way. Because I was talking about Lucifer and Gabriel, and there being a connection between them. And then that song came on. Send Me an Angel. Real life. That's who does it. Real life. This is real life. Evermore. Evermore are a Kiwi band. Real Life is also the record label of Peter Gabriel. For the I don't know, Us. I think it was Us. But you'll find Red Rain is a song on So, the album So. It has Red Rain and it has Sledgehammer. So, I want to be your sledgehammer. Well, that's how it is. The prophecy is a sledgehammer because the hurricane is worse than a sledgehammer, okay? So I'm turning up the radio now and I'm just going to listen to music. Along here, so I sort of will talk some of the time. I don't know who does that song, but I think it might be Bruno Mars. If that's not Bruno Mars, then call me an idiot. I don't care. It's like, kind of reminds me of Yiming Yuen and the fact that he suffered through all that pain, and people say, oh yeah, he deserves it, he's a drug trafficker. It's like, a lot of people do stupid things in life and they don't get strapped to a wooden trestle and flogged 24 times with a rattan cane at category 5 intensity. You know what I mean? So I look at it a little differently. He suffered something that very few people do in terms of the mental suffering that even before the physical trauma, agony, excruciating agony, and knowing it's coming for days and not knowing when it's coming, and watching the person before you suffer, knowing that you're going to be next, all of this in the lead up to the event, all of this knowing you've got 20 years in jail. I look at that and I see a martyr, actually, a martyr. I see a Christian in the real meaning of the word. Like I said, there's a connection between Lucifer and Gabriel, the angels, Archangel, Gabriel, and a monster that's taken the name Gabrielle as her name. Just like last year, we had a monster in the Gulf of Mexico take the name Michael, the name of an angel. And this is what monsters do. They take the names of angels, they disguise themselves as angels, and then they come out killing and destroying and maiming. And Yiming Yuen was the victim of exactly that type of monster. So he knows all about Gabriel.
In the park. feels good. Hello, you fool. I love you.
And Joyride at Mix 106.3, music that makes you feel good. Now we're spending a bit of time with Flynn here. Of course, Johnny Flynn, he's the singer, songwriter, actor who's set to play David Bowie in an upcoming movie about the legend's life. But Flynn is also a suburb in Canberra, and the most recent to be celebrated by Kristen and Nige's suburban song.
Flynn, last night I dreamed that Gabriel had a surname. Byrne. B-Y-R-N-E. Byrne. Gabriel Byrne. And the Australian Federal Police had set up a press conference, and they had wanted posters for Gabriel Byrne. And it was like a play that was being put on by the ANU students, but the police had decided to present it as if it was a real life thing, and Gabriel Byrne was like a murderer, wanted. And so they were doing it was like a publicity stunt to get people, get people's attention for the play. And it worked, because I couldn't even tell if it was real or not. And it was like Gabriel Byrne, murderer. I had a photo and everything. So that was kind of weird. That was my dream last night. And a couple of nights ago, I dreamed that Yiming Yuen was flying a plane. A little plane. But he was flying it up. Hey, there's a bird, a crow. Don't know if you can see it. And it was like, yeah, he was flying a plane. It was like, at first, I thought it was too small to fly. But he jumped in when it got started and off he went. Right up in the sky, and then he joined like a whole armada of planes, and they're all flying north. So that was actually the night that I filmed the plane. I saw a plane, I filmed a plane after I was shining the torch on the blue gongs, and I said there's a warning from Gabriel, the angel, about Gabriel, the monster hurricane. And I'm shining the torch up in the blue gums. And then the wind came up after I said, there's something wrong with Gabriel. And I said something about the shadow, I think, of Michael and Gabriel. And then the wind came whipping up. There was a cold front coming through. But the wind just came up savagely right after I said that. And then I turned around and there's a plane. And it had a spotlight shining through the clouds. And that night I dreamed that Yiming Yuen was flying a plane. He was at a park. And he unpacked his plane and he set it up. And it was at first like I thought, oh, it's a model plane. No, it's like a plane. It's a real plane. Surely it's not big enough to fly. He jumps in and sure enough, off it goes. Up into the sky. So joyride reminded me of my dream just then. So when was that? Today's the 21st. Of August 2019, so I guess we're talking 3 nights ago when I had that dream. I'd say that's about right. Must have been the 18th. And that was a dream that I had kind of during the night. But the dream I had this morning about the Australian Federal Police press conference and the ANU students doing the play with Gabriel Byrne, the villain, the murderer. Well, that was right before I woke up. And after I woke up, I was like, oh, what was the name? Because I knew it was Gabriel with a surname in the dream. And I was like, what was it? You know how when you just wake up, if you can get it straight away, if you can remember it straight away, then you've got it. But if you don't get it straight away, you've lost it. It was like that, and then I got it. I thought, oh, it was Byrne. Because I actually remembered seeing what I saw. Gabriel Byrne. Yeah, weird, really weird. Because American Hurricane has this, well, if you add up all the letters in American Hurricane, they add up to 135. Daniel and Samuel adds up to 135. They are the identical twins in Red Rain by R.L. Stine. The eruption of Steamboat Geyser happened almost, like, just, it happened just before my dream, I guess. Because when I woke up, it had happened 2 hours earlier, from memory. And because it wasn't yet 2 hours, or it might have been just over 2 hours ago, since it erupted. And it erupted at 51 minutes past the hour, 51 minutes after midday. So 12:51. Angelic equals 51, demon equals 51, deadly equals 51, Michael equals 51, Hugo equals 51. And Hugo came in onto the east coast of the USA at Charleston, South Carolina. And I thought this one, the bad one this year, there's already been a fairly decent storm in Barry, but the real bad one this year is going to hit the east coast, but it's going to be lower than Hugo. That's why I looked at the map and I thought about there. And when I looked about there and looked at the map, it was Jacksonville. That's how I found the place. Just by going, it's going to come in about there. And that's where there was when I looked at the map. Jacksonville, and then moving north, I think. So Brunswick in Georgia is going to get it too. So Gabriel, a monster, hurricane in 2019, a destroyer, a killer, a torturer, a bitch, and you don't want to mess with her. If you can get out of her way, take that opportunity and get out of the way, because her storm surge is going to be utterly deadly. Deadly, devastating, destructive, just like Michael. So Michael, Hugo, are like brothers in a way. Category 5s, they have the same value, 51. Identical twins. Gabriel. Archangel names, Michael and Gabriel. And then Daniel and Samuel. Well, this is where it really gets weird, because Jake's killer, as in Jake Wetzling, his killer, was Danny Heinrich. And we used to have a neighbor named Danny Byrne, spelt the same way. Byrne, B-Y-R-N-E. Danny Byrne, so his name was Daniel. And he was killed in a freak accident involving a tree and a chainsaw, a willow tree and a chainsaw, bang, killed him. It pinned him, bang, in the chest. That's a long time ago. But Danny is the name of Jake's killer. So like a reflection in that sense, Danny and Danny. And then Nathan has the same value as Danny, 58. It's also the value of steam. Steam is 58. A steamboat geezer sign. Steamboat, 96. Red rain, 69. Reflecting. Everything's reflecting. It's a mirror image. Identical twins are a mirror image of each other. They reflect. If one is left-handed, the other's right-handed. Daniel and Samuel, the identical twins in red rain. Red rain is 69, steamboat is 96. So Danny Byrne, our neighbor who died back in 2000, a long time ago, around 2002, I don't know, maybe even earlier than that, 2001, 2000, I don't know, around then. And I went to his funeral. I talked to him, I had a nice conversation with him the last time I saw him. And it was on New Year. I found out on New Year's Day, and I was sick. I had food poisoning on the day I found out, from oysters or from prawns that were bad. I had shocking pain. I couldn't even drive. I had to get a kid to drive the car. I was doubled over in agony. And, like, that was the day I found out that Danny Byrne had died. I always said Burns, but his name was actually Byrne, and his surname. And there's a connection between his family and my family. So for that name to come up in my dream all these years later as the surname of Gabriel in a dream where there's wanted posters being put up by the Australian Federal Police, well, that's bizarre, because the other day I was making a video and an Australian Federal Police officer came and wanted to know what I was doing because I was near a school and I was filming. So he was like, what are you doing? He was suspicious, understandable. And I was like explaining to him, oh, well, I think Hurricane Gabriel is going to hit Jacksonville in Florida. So I said, I'm just filming the clock, the time on the clock, so that it's in my video when I make the video. And he was like, very suspicious at first, and then he was like, okay. Because he looked at my video, a little bit of my video, and goes, okay. So, no worries. And then he goes, Jacksonville, Florida, huh? Because I didn't have Florida on my thing, I just had Jacksonville. So he knew Jacksonville. It's a pretty big place. There's well over 1 million people there. So for a major hurricane to hit that city is bad news. It's low level. The St. John's River runs right through there. A big, massive storm surge hitting a place like that with people still there is a worst case scenario as far as you could see a death toll in the many, many thousands. So this is serious stuff. Song, which I just played a bit of, from memory, if I have that song in the video, it's gonna cause a copyright breach. Because I think I've had that song before, and I had to silence it. I had to edit it out. So I guess there's no point having it in the video if I'm going to make the video public. But it's a song that sort of does match what I was just saying. A little, in a way, it's a little spooky. I don't know what it's called now. I don't know the name of the song off the top of my head. I'll put it in the description if I get around to it. And if I don't get around to it and you listen to this and you're like, oh, well, I wonder what song it was, well, just send me a message. Ask me and I'll put it in there. Because, to be honest, I have no idea when I'm going to upload any of these videos. And to upload videos, I have to go to the library and I usually have a limited amount of time, and it's like I don't really have time to put very good descriptions on my videos. And then I don't even know what videos what half the time. I end up uploading the same video twice, and it's like, oh, that was a waste of time. And it's like, yeah, but it gets difficult. It's difficult because there's so much stuff you've got to consider. Like, it's annoying. Like, copyright stuff. Well, I don't mind that they put ads in, but when they say, oh, this video is can't be played anywhere, it's like, oh my god, like, honestly, it's so banal. It's still going. It's about to end. Way Down. You know that song, yeah? You probably know it.
Way Down We Go here at Mix 106.3. Hi, it's Pat here playing music the most.
Way Down We Go.
Another chance to feel good tomorrow morning with Kristen and Night with Mobile Phone Bingo. Brand new card started this.
If you are making a video and you want to put the video on YouTube and you're at a party, there's a whole list of songs you can't have in your video. Or it'll cause a copyright issue that you can't overcome unless you completely wipe the audio from that part of your video. And it's kind of going to wreck your video. So, well, it's going to make it like people are going to be watching, going, what happened to the sound? I think there's something wrong with their laptop or something wrong with their phone. And they're going to be like, what's going on? There's something wrong with YouTube. And it's not that at all. It's that you've had to edit the sound out of your video for the video to not be banned. Because there's some bit of a song in there by some anal, I don't know what they are, record label. Who makes this decision? AC/DC. I love AC/DC, but you can't have an AC/DC song in your video. It's like, so whoever makes these decisions, they are obviously very anal. I think that's the right word for it. Anal. It's like, oh yeah, we're not gonna sell enough records if people can have our music on YouTube in the background of their videos. Oh well, people aren't gonna buy it. Like, honestly, seriously, are you crazy? It's like free publicity for a song. It could remind someone that they like the song. It's like, oh, I forgot all about that song. Oh, I forgot all about that band. Oh, I used to have that record. I don't have it anymore. I should get it or download that song. You know, honestly, it's talk about shoot yourself in the foot. I don't understand some people. It's like the desire to protect the money-making ability of the corporation actually reduces its money inflow. That's what happens. It's It's like countries that focus exclusively on economics end up shooting themselves in the feet, like Australia has done, on the issue of climate change, shooting itself in the feet. Because Australia is a country that, I mean, where this drought now is just unbelievably bad. Unbelievably bad. And it was, I thought it's so ironic that Alan Jones got himself in hot water by saying that Scott Morrison should shove a sock down the throat of Jacinda Ardern. I thought that's so ironic for a shock jock to get into trouble using shock jock language. For starters, that's ironic. But secondly, even more ironic is the fact that he's telling someone who is, you know, like Scott Morrison's out actually doing a visit to the Pacific Islands on the issue of climate change, and Jacinda Ardern is like, yeah, we need to take action on climate change, and Alan Jones, a climate change denier, of which there are many in Australia, and many climate change denying shock jocks have been bashing our ears for the last decade non-stop. The last decade? Yeah, about that. That's when it went to full-on denial, right after Black Saturday. Right after Nathan Breeze died with 172 other people, including his two sisters and his mum. It was right after that that a lot of, I don't know, what are they? What are climate change deniers? Like, what do they all have in common? They like calling other people stupid. Rowan Dean does that. Yesterday he was calling other people stupid, and he's a climate change denier. Ironic, hey? Oh, they're so stupid. People are so stupid. It's so stupid. I'll tell you what's stupid. Climate change denial is stupid. And it's so ironic. It's Alanis Morissette of ironic when they are calling other people stupid and telling other people to put a sock in it. Well, they can't even say the right words because they're so used to being a shock jock, they say, shove a sock down her throat. And then they get accused of inciting the Australian Prime Minister to murder the Prime Minister of New Zealand in the most cruel way imaginable. Which is kind of funny. Shock jocks getting into trouble from using shock jock language. And telling other people to put a sock in it. When that's all they've done for 10 years is bash our eardrums with climate change denial garbage, which has now reached the incredible point of Donald Trump. Like the pinnacle of climate change denial is when the Trump administration releases a little thing on a Friday night, hoping no one will notice it, because they want it to be in the law, but they don't want anyone to know they did it. Carbon dioxide is no longer considered a greenhouse gas. When people in government are writing about, like describing what carbon dioxide is, it's no longer a greenhouse gas. That's not how we call it. We don't call it a greenhouse gas. We call it molecules of freedom. I mean, was this like suggested by Kim Jong-un in one of those love letters or something? Because seriously, it sounds like something right out of North Korea. Like cheap, almost like propaganda that you'd laugh at if it wasn't coming from the American government. If it was North Korea saying, let's call it freedom gas. If it's natural gas, let's call it freedom gas. And if it's carbon dioxide, let's call it molecules of freedom. You'd laugh at that if it was North Korea. But when it's the American government putting that into legislation, well, man, that is kind of scary. And that was just a few months ago. Because it's just such blatant propaganda that it means I must have switched worlds at some point. Like I went from the world I used to be in where the Nazis lost the war because they were good at propaganda and they were good at torturing people, to the world where killing people as well. The world where, because like honestly, Julian Assange, I think he's facing 750 years jail. So that's because why? He exposed people who had killed people. there were people that had killed people in the military, right? Civilians and journalists were killed by people in the US military, and he exposed this and a lot of other stuff. Like, there's a lot of two-faced hypocrisy goes on in government, and he exposed it all. And so he's facing 750 years jail. And I think it's about that. And all I can say is that there is some light. There is some light, there is some hope for Julian Assange. There is some light in the dark tunnel, because what has happened is the reclassification of carbon dioxide as freedom gas means that everyone now has, how now everyone, because carbon dioxide is not just in America, it's a global phenomenon. So everybody on Earth now has access to freedom gas. And all you have to do is breathe. If you're breathing, you're getting freedom gas. Not freedom gas, that's natural gas. So to get that, if you want freedom gas, you have to actually breathe natural gas. That'll probably kill you. So don't do that. But just breathing, you're getting molecules of freedom. Okay, molecules of freedom are going into your lungs all the time, because that's what they are. It's no longer a greenhouse gas. It's molecules of freedom under US law. So every time you breathe in, you're breathing in molecules of freedom. So even Yi Ming Yuen in Singapore, he's getting some freedom, molecules of freedom inside his lungs, thanks to Donald Trump. And so is Julian Assange. So maybe there comes a point where you've got so many molecules of freedom inside your body that you break free. Like Yi Ming Yuen did in my dream the other night, and you just start flying. And that's it. 69. That little truck in front of me, that's its number plate. 69. The 6th of the 9th, a sign from the steamboat. On the 6th of the 9th, there's going to be an eruption of the steamboat. 1:37 a.m. in Canberra is 9:37 a.m. in Wyoming. Being Wyoming, it's the day before. It's the 5th of September and it's Thursday. We can catch up next Thursday at 1 p.m. Jake just said I'd better shut up, or people are going to tell me to put a sock in it. And I'm like, yeah, fair enough, too. Fair enough, too. Fair enough. I have talked a bit too much. But that's because every time I go to turn the radio on, there's some stupid ad on, or there's a song that's copyrighted. So what am I to do, man? Change stations, says Nathan. Why don't you just change the station?
60 years of service and still going strong.
Shake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge. You want on it, you want me to teach thee techniques that freaks these boys. They can't be bought. Just let this get caught. Watch if you're smart. La 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 la. Warm it up. La 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 la. The boys are waiting. La 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 la. Warm it up. La 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 la. The boys are waiting. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge.
Once you get involved, everyone will look this way, so you must maintain your charm. Same time, maintain your halo. Just get the perfect lens. That's what your helmet said. Then next, his eyes are squint. Then he's picked up your scent.
La 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 la. Warm it up. La 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 la. The boys are waiting. La 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 la. Warm it up. La 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 la.
Chick brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge.
It's a hits and old school workday. Canberra's Hit 104.7. Autoco Car Maintenance Workshops. Feel empowered and book your tickets at autoco.com.au.
I'm done hating myself for feeling. I'm done crying myself away. I gotta leave and start the healing.
Keep calling you Kathleen. Anyway, have a great Arvo. Just in time.
Bye. Phil, you too. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Gunner, kick his lily ass!
So did he pray?
Tattoo, yeah, he's getting ink done. He asked for a 13, but they drew a 31. Friends say he's trying too hard, and that right hip, but in his own mind, he's not.
He's the dumbest.
And every single Post Malone fan of the world was super excited when we heard this news last month.
The reason my voice is kind of fucked is because I was in the studio for the last 3 days and we just finished up the new album.
Yeah, according to his manager, it is the album of the year and it's going to come before the end of 2019. I'm so excited about that. We got this song to spin in the meantime. Goodbyes, Post Malone, on Canberra C44.7.
Me and Kurt feel the same, too much pleasure is pain. My girl spites me in vain, all I do is complain. She needs something to change, need to take out the ass. So fuck it all tonight. And don't tell me to shut up, when you know you talk too much. But you don't got to say, I want you out. Good at goodbyes. We're both acting insane. Much love in the chains. I'm drinking again. Proof in my veins and my fingers stained. Looking over the eyes.
I just realized something. 21st of August. It's the birthday of somebody. 16 degrees. It's the birthday of the first kid that ever overheard me talking about a weather